ya wahda alpinist.
Uġejt issa sal-villaġġ pittoresk tal-Arp li huwa l-aktar villaġġ fil-punent ta' Għawdex u li fih jgħixu numru ta' barranin li integraw sew mal-awċin tal-lokal. Tnejn minn dawn huma ħbib tiegħi, Matthew u Lena Scurfield, li ilhom jgħixu hawn il-fuq minn 15-il sena.
Cheers. So good to see you again. It's always nice to listen to you tell me about the fascinations of Gozo through your eyes. In fact, that's what's going to be my first question. What fascinates you about Gozo?
You want to go first?
I suppose it's, first of all, it's the people, without any question. I recognize myself. And so many of them are not, they have these garages, for instance. A lot of the boys or young men, a lot of the men here have garages which they fiddle about in, but they really do stuff. And I'm a bit like that, I think, at heart.
So you see yourself?
Yes, I think that's what, that's one of the big things that attracts me, but also the countryside and the whole, the light, just the beauty of it is to me. I mean, I walk every day into the country. I mean, that's when I last saw you.
Exactly. I went for a walk in Arp and I bumped into him.
I know, you really don't believe.
Yeah. Walking it was so strange.
But that's how, especially
at that time of the day, the sunsets and the whole thing, like, it's just
beautiful.
It is.
What about for you?
Well, yes, the people, amazing, slowly getting to know them, you're on the street. The sense of community is still very strong here, and that's exceptional these days. Well, certainly in a lot of places. And the light, I would agree, is just, for me, a big thing. And being near the sea, you know, that sense it's a small island, but having the closeness to the sea gives something. You know, between the light and the sea, and the light on the sea, and the landscape, and the small fields. I have just a very special feeling for them. I think they're amazing.
Do you see yourself as expats who have integrated, or who have made friends with other expats?
I don't think I ever came, I can't speak for Lena, obviously, but I don't think I ever came here with that view in mind. I came here in the knowledge of knowing that I would have to deal with my, because it's a bit difficult to explain, but one spends a lot of time on one's own here. So because you're alone, if the mind is agitated, that is what you're faced with. So in a way, you grow stronger, hopefully. I'm growing stronger by being here, not in, you know, brutish physical strength, but just in the realization that there's much more to life.
And you don't find it small?
No, because I think the people are big. In a way, the people are big. They're very contained in themselves, but they're also, they work like nobody else works. I mean, it's difficult to talk about the Maltese and the Gozotans, but they are very different. The Gozotans are certainly very shrewd, and they know what it, I think the echoes of the past are still with them,
yes,
in a way, and they know, and if push comes to shove, and we all go under with this COVID-19 and the whole thing, of hopefully we won't, and obviously I don't think we will, but if we did, I think you would see them survive here, because they still work the fields. They just do. They're like all the boys. I mean, they go hunting and things, but they definitely, they love their vegetables and they love their chickens, and they keep a cow. The odd ones keep a cow.
I mean, I think the young people won't all be doing that anymore, but there's still many of them. Are connected.
Yes.
Maybe not like their fathers were, but there is still that connection. And there is, as you said, I feel very much which is part of the specialness here, that the park isn't that far away. It's not close, but you can still feel it.
So, Lena, the preservation of the uniqueness and the things that you love about Gozo and others love about Gozo need to be preserved. And what are they? What would they be, in your opinion?
Well, I suppose the balance of the size of everything, you know, as I think about it. You know, something overpowers the actual what's going on, what's already here. That can easily get out of balance and the harmony can go. And now it's something, I don't know how one monitors these things on an overall basis, but it would take really, I think, a planned insight into how the island is developing. Because I think everybody comes here because it is what it is. It can easily become something else very quickly, and that would be a shame. Not stopping progress, because obviously people need work, people need to get to places. That's very clear.
Yes, but the balance.
Yes.
And it's not only about the balance of perhaps geographically how it is and also the infrastructure, but it's also about the people perhaps as well.
Yes.
A balance between, because at the moment I see that there's a beautiful mixture of the Gozitans, the locals, and people like yourselves who have become locals.
Yes, I agree, but I think the locals have to take precedence. Now, I don't know how, again, you would monitor something like that, because it's the ideal things aren't very easy. You can't enforce them. Mm-hmm. I don't know. Now, maybe it is how many people are allowed to buy houses. This happens in other places. I think that's something that would be worth looking at. Young people, how do they find homes here now? So that's very important. And the local people have to come first, in my opinion.
Dejjem sabiħ li tisma l-għozza li għandhom in-nies dwar din il-gżira ġojjel ta' Għawdex mhijiex għal kulħadd, imma għal xi wħud hija kollox.
If you enjoyed watching my local travels around Gozo, then make sure to like, share and subscribe for more.
The local traveler would like to thank Visit Gozo, Visit Malta, Dahlia Real Estate, Ministry for the Economy, Investment and Small Businesses, and Arts Council Malta.